God is love. It looks a funny idea to what they think we as Catholics believe God to be. There are a thousand more images. So a lot of people think we believe that some Zeus-like God was a human being, but the more powers than us who can make bodies, storms, create planets, and do all this. That's good when you're in grade three. That's the one the atheists are going to attack us for. We don't believe in that. That is not our God. God, the great chess player, is another image people have of someone who plays chess in our lives, someone who does bad things to good people. How could God do this to that person? How could God allow that to happen? Again, that's a grade three understanding of God. That's not the God we worship in this church. That's not our faith. We don't believe in that God either. But the God we do believe in, which is the heart of everything we do, but the heart of what Kyle and Karina will commit themselves to today, is love itself. God is love. We love each other, but God is love. And when I talk about love, I'm not talking about grade three love, which we see in the secular world, which is all about fluff and romance and the bachelorette and fun with the wife and what we're going to be watching now, Love at First Sight, Married at First Sight, something like that. I love those shows. But that's a grade three understanding of love. And too many people think that's what love is all about. Fluff and romance and Valentine's Day and roses and chocolates and living happily ever after like some princess in a palace. But anyone who's been in love for any length of time will know that love is much deeper than that. It's far more profound and often wounds us and hurts us. The most powerful symbol of love we have in our tradition, which Kyle and Karina will know well as they go forward in their marriage life, is the love of the cross. The cross which is up there, which reminds us that love is sometimes dead. But love is always life here. Love is stronger than death. Love can enable us not only to open the eyes to our own blindness and cure us of our deafness, but it helps us to walk in new ways. Profound ways, deep ways that make life worth living, and despite the trials and tribulations, despite all the joys, the happiness, the laughter, and the tears that will come from this day, it is the love that will keep us together and make us stronger and enable us to face whatever the world throws at us and triumph over it. That is the message of the cross, and it's the message of the resurrection. That not even death can take love away if we choose not to give it up. Love is at the heart of the sacrament of marriage. It's through the love that Pat, Kyle and Karina will show each other this day and every day forward. They show the face of our God. If you want to see the God we worship in this church, the real God, not the imaginary God people think we worship, look into Kyle and Karina's eyes in a few moments when together they pronounce their vows. Their undying commitment to lay down their lives so completely, so much in the image of that cross for the sake of each other. But in laying down their lives in such a way, they take them up again in ways that are life-giving and will create new life in the family that they will bring into the world, in the home that they will build, into the hope and the joy that they will show us as we are inspired by their love, touched by their love, moved by their love, challenged by their love, every time we encounter it. Their marriage is a sacrament of God's love present in their lives. And it cannot exist without the face of God, who is love itself, being central to that commitment. Not fluffy romantic love, but the hardcore love that looks into the other and sees not the faults, but only the beauty. It's prepared to lay down everything to see that the other can be all that they can be with the gifts that God has given her or him. Be prepared to go through something as challenging as that crucifixion for the sake of the other, so that the other can know life in its fullness. This isn't easy. This isn't soft. This isn't fluffy, this isn't romantic, but it is real, it is deep, it is profound, and it is life-giving, and it will be inspirational for each and every one of us every single day we encounter it with them. So today we celebrate a sacred covenant that Kyle and Karina invite God into their lives, invite divine love into their lives, and through that divine love, take themselves through the best and worst of everything that comes from this day forward until death as they part but briefly. Because love is stronger than death. In the resurrection, they will be together forever. This is our faith. This is the real God we worship in this church. This is the heart and road of this sacrament and every sacrament. Today we are honored to be part of Kyle and Karina's life.